Welcome to our instructional video on servicing our hydraulic swaging tools. Let's start with the DIY servicing packs. Included in the bag is two sets of spring retainers and grub screws for the die sets, one rubber seal, ball bearing and pin for the on-off valve, two spare clips for the handle, two complete sets of seals for the pump valve, one piston O-ring and one spring pin. Start by unscrewing the handle. If this is firm, you can use a vise to secure the body. Remove the cap from the oil bag and start to drain the oil from the tool. Remove the O-ring, securing the bag in place on the tool. Be careful not to pierce the bag with any sharp instruments. Remove the handle. Do this by removing the retaining clips from the two pins. The pins can be tapped out using a punch if necessary. Unscrew the press head. If any die sets are in the tool, they will need to be removed. If the grub screw is protruding from the piston, make sure to screw this in as well. Remove spring, remove the valve pin. Next, remove the on-off valve by tapping out the spring pin. You may need to peel back the sticker to do this. Inside this is the ball bearing which can be tapped out. A replacement for this is inside your kit. Remove the piston. This is friction fitted. On the base you will find two filters which will need to be removed, as well as two magnets which are stuck to the inside of the wall of the body. was to remove parts and body thoroughly. For this, we are using clutch and brake cleaner. However, any hydraulic cleaner will work. We would also recommend using an aerosol as it makes it easier to remove the buildup of contaminants. Spray the filters from inside out to clear any blockages. Remove the O-ring from the piston and replace with your new one from the servicing kit. It is important to lubricate new seals with grease. However, if you do not have any, a small dab of hydraulic oil will work also. Fit the piston back into the tool. Reinstall the magnets and filters by push fitting. Replace the O-ring on your on-off valve. This is also included in the service kit. Place in the ball bearing and screw the valve into the fully on position. You can then refit the spring pin. Now we need to change the four seals inside the handle valve. This comprises two white nylon seals and black rubber O-rings. Start by removing the oil seals and replace any as per the diagram. This can take some time and requires perseverance. It is best to push the seals beyond the channels and pull them back into place. Push fit the handle valve pin. Refit the spring and press head. Reinstall the bag again, making sure not to pierce the bag with any sharp tools. Reattach the O-ring to secure in place. Refill the tool with oil. Recommended oil for this tool is ISO 32 hydraulic oil. You are looking to fill the tool to the top, however, ensure that it does not overflow. Refit the cap and both handles. When you begin to test the tool, you may find air pockets in the system preventing the tool from working. Pump the handle multiple times all the way to the maximum pressure. If this does not clear the blockage, then remove the handle again. Top up the oil and repeat the process until it's working. For any more information on our hydraulic tool servicing, visit www.techni.uk or contact any of our sales team by emailing sales@techni.uk.